Hello, my name is Dr. Diwan S. Raja. Today I will discuss about oogenesis, the female gametogenesis. We have questions, we'll answer those questions. So what are the primordial germ cells? The primordial germ cells are the cells which are developed in the wall of the yolk sac, and they go through repeated cell division, migrate to the ovarian cortex and form the oogonium, that is the primordial ovum. So that is the ovum here, and that oogonium will be replicated to form primary oocyte. So here 46 chromosome, 2n DNA. After replication, we have 46 chromosome, 4n DNA. Okay. At birth, we have no oogonium. At birth, we have 1 to 2 million primary oocyte. So this replication happened around the 5th month of intrauterine life. How primary oocytes are formed? Primary oocytes are formed from oogonium by replication of DNA. What is the number of chromosome in primary oocyte? In primary oocyte, we have 46 chromosome and 4n DNA. Okay. So how the primary oocyte remain dormant? Primary oocyte go through the meiosis 1. Okay. But it is arrested in prophase 1 during diploten. We call it dictyoten stage. Okay, so in dictyoten stage, it is arrested in prophase 1 and it will be arrested until puberty. At puberty, around 10 to 15 primary oocyte will go through the development, and one of them will be ultimately the ovum. Okay, so at birth we have 1 to 2 million oocyte. We have no oogonium. Each month from puberty to menopause will have, every cycle, menstrual cycle, around 10 to 20 primary oocyte will go through development. One of them will be able to form to become an mature ovum. So what is the oocyte maturation inhibitor? We have follicular cell around the oogonium. Initially they are flattened, then they become cuboidal. Eventually they even become columnar. There will be cavity formation. We call it mature follicle around the developing ovum. Okay, so this cell has the capacity to produce oocyte maturation inhibitor. So not necessarily the oogonium will go through these stages because of the presence of oocyte maturation inhibitor to inhibit the oogonium, or to the primary oocyte, to the secondary oocyte. That is actually inhibited by OMI. So this happen, this ovulation happen only after puberty. Okay. And that is also controlled. Not necessarily all primary oocyte will start to mature at the same time. Only 10 to 20 will mature at the same cycle. What is the role of luteinizing hormone SARS on primary oocyte? The luteinizing hormone SARS is very essential for ovulation. For ovulation, the ovum is coming out of the follicle. There is the pre-ovulatory mature follicle. It is a cavity. Cavity indicates a secondary follicle. These are multilayered primary follicle. It is unilayered primary follicle. Okay. This is the developing ovum. This. What is the outcome of fertilization and what are the polar bodies? Okay, if you go to the previous slide, outcome fertilization. Okay, so the ovum is discharged in the secondary oocyte stage. Okay, but its second meiotic stage is not completed. Okay, we have the ovulated secondary oocyte, and this has started the second meiotic division. First meiotic division is over. Now second meiotic division has started, and it will be arrested in meiosis II. It will be only completed second meiotic division once the secondary oocyte is penetrated by a sperm. Once the sperm penetrated, then what will happen? There will be zygote formation, and the second meiotic division will be completed. Okay. What are the polar bodies? Polar bodies are the small component of the cell, the oogonia or the maturing oogonia cells without cytoplasm. These are the polar cells. So if you go to the previous image, we have the polar bodies. We have the polar bodies, and these are the polar bodies. These are the division of primary oocyte. One is secondary oocyte. Another cell, yes, it is nuclear material, but it has no cytoplasm. Okay, and this cell degenerates. Again, here when second meiotic division is completed, we get another polar body, and that also degenerates. It has no cytoplasm. It is just nucleus. Okay, how many primary oocytes are present at 5th month of fetal life? If you go to that picture again, at the fetal life, it should be around 5 million of oogonium. At birth, we have primary oocyte 1 to 2 million. Okay, what is the approximate number of ovulation throughout the reproductive life of a female? Okay, suppose a 28-day cycle. Okay, so every year around 12 ovulation will occur. Okay, around 12 ovulation. So if a lady has 40 years of reproductive life, starting from puberty to menopause, then 40 times 12, so that should be around 480 ovulation, but this does not happen when they are pregnant. No ovulation. If they take oral contraceptive pill, there will be no ovulation. Even under stressful situation, there will be no ovulation. But on approximately maximum around 480 ovulation, 480 ovulation may happen. What is the role of hormones in gametogenesis? Certainly, we have hormone from anterior pituitary gland. Follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, which will stimulate the follicle around the oocyte, primary oocyte. There will be cavity formation, there will be multi-layered follicular cell. Okay, there will be mature follicle. Okay, that are done by the follicle stimulating hormone from anterior pituitary. We'll also have anterior pituitary luteinizing hormone that will surge, and that will cause expulsion of the ovum, that is the ovulation, by the luteinizing hormone surge. Okay, we have also formation of, we have also estrogen progesterone from the ovary. From the thecal cell, we have the ovary. From the corpus luteum, we have the progesterone. Okay, they have individual role in the growth of the endometrium of the uterus. Okay, progesterone and estrogen, after ovulation, they will build up the thickness of the endometrium. And that's all about the oogenesis and female gametogenesis. If you have any question, please feel free to ask me. Please share the information with your friends. Please support my channel. And please subscribe me. Have a nice day. Bye now.